Well, hello, this is Peter Combs from bitemout.com, bitemoutlive.com, and P.L. Combs Asian Art in Gloucester, Massachusetts. And today is Wednesday, October 13th, 2021. And today, we haven't done one of these videos in a while, but I've gotten a lot of phone calls, and it's time to talk about Charlottes down in Florida. Enough is enough. All right, and this is my opinion. I'm just going to say that right up front, and you can take it for what it's worth. But they are having another auction of items they claim now are from the collection of C.T. Liu. Those of you who know who C.T. Liu is, he was the most prominent collector, dealer, aficionado, pretty much in the history of Asian art dealing. He's one of the top one or two most well-known dealers going back to the early part of the 20th century. He was a major influencer up until the time that he died in 1957. And this auction house is claiming that they have a bunch of lots that were bought at an auction in Paris in 1912, which is ridiculous. If they're claiming it came from C.T. Liu for a whole lot of reasons, and we're going to go through it. All right, I'm going to go through it. C.T. Liu had in 1912 was operating in Paris. He opened his gallery there around 1908. But by 1910, he was already focusing mostly on the United States. He kept his Paris store, of course, but he wasn't running auctions, and he certainly wasn't consigning things under the mystery name of CT, which is what this company is claiming. All right, and here is a little bit more about Charlottes, in case you're wondering. The company's been in business for a little over a year, from what I can see, or they've been on Live Auctioneers for a little over a year. They started back August 30th of last year was their first auction, and since then, they seem to have miraculously come across more important art collections of Asian art than Sotheby's, Christie's, and Bonhams combined, including in one of their sales here, they claim that this is the art collection by the Yamanaka Company, of all things, and then other prominent Chinese figures and so on and so forth. And from what I can see, everything they sell is a copy. That's my general impression, is that everything they sell and none of it comes from any famous collections at all. It would be easy enough to sit here and say, well, maybe if some consigner misled them. Not when you turn up this many, you begin to wonder what's going on. The collection of Mele and Fang, the collection of this, the collection of that guy. And of course, none of it is verifiable. We're just going to go through it. On their website this time around, they're just saying is honored to present a phenomenal antique and art collection of C.T. Liu. This stunning collection covers various intricate porcelain, ceramics, paintings, and calligraphy, and so on. Now, the question is whether or not they have a live audience. If they have a live audience, they are probably in violation of several Florida laws regarding auctions and auction licenses, and certainly the UCC code, because Florida has fairly strict auction laws. And one of them is you can't misstate, misrepresent, or anything else. And if you claim things like provenance and make those sort of claims, you better be able to back it up if they come knocking. But I have a suspicion the state of Florida is not that all interested, as they typically aren't in the art world, unless somebody really famous gets hurt, and then they'll put the FBI on them. But for now, let's just take a look at the catalog and see what the heck's going on. And to give you some idea, I mean, here's the stuff they claimed that was from the Yamanaka Company. And incredibly rare looking bowls, Yung Chen peach bowls going for $5,000, not $500,000, that kind of thing. And then they have things like this in their last sale, a painting signed by Zhu Bei Hong, and the implication is that it's by this artist. It's not by Zhu Bei Hong. The original, this painting, actually sold in 2012. Here it is. For 10 million Hong Kong, 11 million Hong Kong, actually, just about $10,964,000, which is, it's $1.5 million U.S., all right? So maybe somebody just got an absolutely amazing steal here. And, of course, it always begs the question, who would consign these lots? And I checked their website over pretty thoroughly. There's no names of anybody. There's no expert on staff. There's no nothing, of course. It appears to be just an auction mill that's been set up. But here are the items, including pictures of C.T. Liu. And what they've done is this is what's caused some confusion among our users. For example, like this piece here, this vase. All right, and in it they have a catalog entry from Monsieur Collection de Monsieur dot C period T. All right. C.T. Lou wasn't really known by this name too much. He was known by it, but it was always Lou. And in a French catalog back then, with the French grammar police, you would have never put in the first two initials. It were, they did use initials sometimes of people, but it would be their full name. You know, Carl Thomas or whatever the French name is. Or they would have said C.T. Lou or C.L. or something else, but not that. Okay, and it looks to me like they dug out, they found an old catalog that this catalog I actually found online. You can order it and download it. You can find copies of it on the internet. Apparently it was a fairly famous auction, but not the property of C.T. Lou. He's nowhere mentioned anywhere in the catalog, which he was a big deal in Paris. He was a growing big deal in Paris at the time, even though by 1912 he was focusing more on his New York store than he was his Paris store. But here's the vase, and in the description that they have, if you want to go through for fun and read their description and dust off your French a little bit, it claims that this is a portrait of figures seated underneath pine trees, okay? Yeah, well, there are pine trees in it, but the major element here are the waves, not the pine trees, all right? And they would have said that, all right? It also has a Yung Chun mark, which isn't mentioned anywhere in the description, which they most certainly would have included. Okay, even back then they did it, and it has a $2,500 to $4,000 estimate, and it's clearly a modern vase. This is not an old vase. This vase has no age to it, beyond maybe 20 or 30 years at the very, very most. All right, and you can mosey through all of their lots the same way. Here's a Ming type vase that they describe as being a vase with flowers. Well, the major element on here are flowers and birds and so forth, and they don't provide any other information. So they found a listing that says flowers. We'll say this is it. Clearly, this is not a Ming vase with these hot red colors and this very stiff, unnatural drawing. It's clearly a modern vase, brand new, all right? And it's already got a bid, startling as that may seem. And then you have things like this. We all recognize this vase. This vase is one of the most famous vases around because the original sold for tens of millions of dollars. And there's been two of them on the market. And within months of this vase being auctioned, the original being auctioned some years ago, copies of these began flooding onto the market. Well, here's another one. All right, here's another one. Okay, and again, claiming it belongs to C.T. Lou. The description nowhere mentions that this vase is reticulated and has fish on it, which was the main feature. It just says it has assorted elements in roundels. No, it has fish in roundels, not assorted elements. All right, and the French are fairly precise in their language. And then you have this one, which claims to be a vase of children. These are adults. Clearly immortals and women and auspicious figures and so forth. And it's clearly not an old vase. That's the other thing. It has a Yung Chen mark on it, but it's clearly a 20th century vase, not something C.T. Lou would have ever seen in a million years because he was dead before it was made. All right, the enameling on it is just absolutely contemporary, brand new, right out of the kilns of Qing De Chen. All right, and if this were an authentic Yung Chen Familial rose vase of any kind in this shape and form, this thing already has eight bids. It has a $5,000 to $8,000 estimate. It is not Qing Dynasty. This was probably made within the last 10 years, all right, or certainly the last 20, and on Blanc de Chine figure. It's got four bids, brand new modern piece, and then you have this bottle vase. They listed strictly as Qing Dynasty. According to the description, translated out of French, it's supposed to have some characters on the bottom, which it doesn't have, or characters anywhere on it. And then the brush pot, which claims to be Qinlong period. There's the base of it. All right. There's the entry, and it says, you know, Baitong, which is a brush pot with dragons on it. But that's it. So they found an entry for dragons. And they put it together with it. And anybody that knows anything about gilding will be able to look at this and in 1 second tell you it's brand new gilding. This is brand new gold paint on blue porcelain. That's all it is. And absolutely nowhere, absolutely nothing. The drawing is mediocre and certainly wasn't done during the Qinlong period. The emperor would have cut your hands off if you handed him this piece. All right. And then over here, there's a painting that they claim is Sung. Ridiculous. That's not how they, that's not a Sung painting. It's not even close. It's a wreck of a painting. It has Chin Lung marks all over it. It's just absolute rubbish. It has four bids. It's up to $750. All I can say is if you're bidding on this, retract your bids. And if you're thinking of bidding on this, these auctions, don't. Please. Don't bid on them. I don't want to tell you you spent $4,000 on a piece of junk. Nothing in this sale, to my eye, is authentic as an antique. Yes, this is made of porcelain, but it's a total piece of rubbish. All of it is rubbish. And I did some looking into this auction house. I can't find out who the owner is. He doesn't tell anybody, or she doesn't say. It's just an address. It's a P.O. box. It looks like it's in some sort of post office down in Florida, in Sarasota. There's no physical address mentioned anywhere other than a P.O. box. And I got a feeling this is strictly an online auction, maybe. And if it is, you can't do physical presence bidding. So they may get around the state auction laws by that, because if you don't have people in the room in many, many states, you're not subject to the state's auction laws. You are always subject to the UCC code, which they seem to be in violation of. But I leave that to a lawyer to look into. If somebody wants to bring a suit, go right ahead. But these people seem to be separating an awful lot of people from their money for absolute nonsense. And this is strictly my personal opinion, but my opinions in the past have been pretty accurate, as you all know. It's not too dissimilar to those auction houses down in Southern Georgia that we've talked about before, the auction house empire. It's now in Boston. It used to be in New York. They decided to move their circus on the road to come up to Boston, and a few others in the Boston area that are particularly notorious. And at some point, this has to stop, and I'm very disappointed that Live Auctioneers allows them any space on this site at all. So that's where we are. So Charlotte's, save your money. Don't have anything to do with this auction. And like I said, if you've placed a bid, retract it. If you're afraid you can't retract it, cut your credit card off. Don't let the bid go through. Let Live Auctioneers know you want to cancel some bids and so forth. The stuff is stylish, obviously new, obviously all reproductions. And this is just a glimpse at some of the stuff they've sold in the past, apparently. And none of it looks authentic. Not one piece is authentic, as far as I can tell. And if I saw a piece that was authentic, I'd say, yeah, that looks pretty good. As you know, I'm more than happy to promote things that look authentic. But none of this stuff looks authentic or have any age whatsoever. It's just piles of nonsense. And do yourself a favor. Collecting is a lot of fun, but it's not a lot of fun if you spend thousands of dollars on fakes, copies, knockoffs, and reproductions. All right, and that's my opinion of this auction, and take it for what it's worth, okay? I love this business, and this kind of stuff just infuriates me beyond belief. And when people come up with a great collection, good auctions, as all of you know, I promote them, I talk about them. I'm not paid to talk about them, but I love collecting. I get excited about collecting, but I also get furious when I see this kind of stuff going on. All right, so leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. Give us a thumbs up if you like these kinds of videos. And have a great day. Have a great rest of your day. We'll be back Friday with the regular video. This auction takes place on Saturday. It's on Saturday. So if you've got bids in there, you've got time to get them off and time to cancel and move on. Okay, bye-bye.